it's the only way that you can make sure that your voice is heard.
Sharon Triplett plans to cast her vote November 6th, and not a day sooner.
Who do you think was trying to get you to vote early?
I didn't know, but, you know, this is a very important election.
Tens of thousands of registered voters in our state received unrequested applications for absentee ballots in the mail. Yeah, Sharon's was already filled out with her personal information.
My name and address, my home.
Not that big of a deal, because your name, address, party affiliation, and how often you vote is public information.
I didn't like it. I honestly didn't like it. I was kind of offended by it.
Oklahoma City University political science professor and registered Democrat voter, Dr. Richard Johnson, also got an unsolicited application.
The first thing I look at is the return address, which is Springfield, Missouri, which is a very socially conservative area. And so I'm thinking, okay, this is something that's Republican oriented or from a conservative group.
Why would Missouri care if people in Oklahoma voted?
We alerted the Oklahoma State Election Board.
That's certainly something that the election board wouldn't do.
But it's not against the law either. These absentee ballot applications are the real thing, the same forms you get from the state.
Most of the phone calls that we're receiving here are just questioning who is this group, how did they get my information.
We know the mailing is from a group called the Center for Voter Information, or CVI, but they're not based in Missouri. Rather, CVI is a tax-exempt 501c4 nonprofit, known as a social welfare group out of Washington, D.C. CVI's program director told us they are a nonpartisan organization with a mission to increase civic engagement among people of color, unmarried women, and millennials. While they claim to be nonpartisan, according to Federal Election Commission filings, they've spent hundreds of thousands of dollars supporting Democrats and opposing Republican U.S. House and Senate candidates.
Ken Buck thinks he's more qualified because he doesn't wear high heels.
Back in 2010, when the group went by the name Women's Voices, Women Vote Action Fund, they paid for this ad in a Colorado U.S. Senate race and spent close to $1 million targeting the Republican nominee.
There are all these entities now, whether they're super PACs or something else, that have very innocuous sounding names.
Like super PACs, social welfare groups like CVI can influence elections by raising and spending unlimited amounts of cash. Although social welfare groups must spend less than half of their money on politics. Another big difference, super PACs must disclose their donors, while social welfare groups can keep the names of their donors hidden from the public.
There's kind of almost a carpetbagger feeling. In other words, I don't want to be influenced by somebody from outside of the state.
CVI spokesperson told us they occasionally issue messaging favoring or opposing particular candidates of different party persuasions. And the mailings they sent voters in our state were intended to encourage Oklahomans, regardless of party preference, to vote in the crucial November elections.
There's a big effort. I mean, Democrats have been trying for 10 years to flip some of the districts that run in some of the metro areas.
Then you go on the bottom line. If you get one of these applications in the mail and have concerns and still want to apply for an absentee ballot,
just ignore what they've sent you and use the official documents and forms that are available on our website.
Now, CVI says in its letter they are not affiliated with state or local election officials. The letter also comes with a paid self-addressed envelope and instructs voters to send in their application to their county election board. If you have any questions about this mailing or any election mailing for that matter, contact the Oklahoma State Election Board for more information. I'm Scott Hines, in your corner.